And let's just start right here because I'm going to be talking a lot about these people. Have you heard of the Lifetime Achievement Award? I'm pretty sure you have. Everyone's heard of the Lifetime Achievement Award. They win the Lifetime Failure Award. What an absolute shit show of a game they put out on the field yesterday against the worst team in the SEC, period. Texas A&M's the worst team in the SEC. Yes, they're worse than Vandy. Yes, they are worse than Vandy. And Texas A&M not only beat LSU, the best the West has to offer. That's the best team the SEC West has to offer. Pitiful. You know what you are, LSU? You're Purdue. You're Purdue. Purdue won the Big Ten West and no one cares because they're terrible. So is the entire Big Ten West. LSU won the SEC West and no one cares because they're terrible and so is the entire SEC West. What a joke. What a joke. You got humiliated by Jimbo Fisher and one player, A-Chain, David or Damon or whatever the hell his name is. They absolutely humiliated you 38-23. They ran all over you. They didn't even bother trying to throw the ball. Boy, that's bad news. That is bad news for LSU heading into their SEC championship game against Georgia because Georgia loves nothing more than to not throw the ball. I'll talk about that when we get to the Georgia Tech-Georgia game here in a few minutes. Georgia loves not throwing the ball. Hell, they're going to beat you into submission. I'm dead serious. They're going to beat the DNA out of you. They're going to have to pull your teeth after this game just to figure out who the hell you are. Send it off to a lab somewhere. What is this? I don't know. We found it. We found it spread out around the 50-yard line of the Mercedes-Benz Dome Saturday night after the SEC championship game. We don't know what it is. A team of scientists is going to come out there. Archaeologists, like what dig for dinosaurs and engine bones and arrows and shit, is going to or rocks or whatever they do. What do they dig for? Engine arrowheads, or whatever they dig for. They're going to get a team of scientists and archaeologists to study what's left. At the Georgia Dome next Saturday night at the SEC title game, they're going to go, oh, yeah, well, after much deliberation and scientific-type analysis and stuff, we've determined this is the remnants of LSU's football program. Oh, okay, yeah, Georgia extincted them. That's what's going to happen next Saturday. But my God, you laid an egg against Texas A&M yesterday. Maybe they were just, they're not that bad, woo. They were looking ahead to the SEC championship. No, they are that bad. They are that bad. This is the same team that beat Arkansas 13-10 a couple of weeks ago. How many games does Jaden Daniels have where he can't even pass for 100 yards? Jaden Daniels is the only thing LSU has offensively. Sort of. They've got some great wide receivers. Jaden Daniels can't get him the ball, though. He's not a good thrower of the ball. He can run around with his legs. That's it. That's not going to work against Georgia. That's not. It's just not enough. LSU, if there was a way to calculate less than 0% of a chance, that's what LSU has next week against Georgia. Georgia is going to absolutely just annihilate LSU and the SEC. This is the most uninteresting SEC championship game I can remember. It's definitely the most uninteresting SEC championship game in the playoff era. Definitely. LSU was a disaster. What a joke. Boy, y'all got destroyed by Texas A&M. A team that has a coach only because they can't afford to fire him. That's the only reason they even have Jimbo Fisher, and they beat you. Brian Kelly, and don't even get me started. Brian Kelly's done great first year at LSU. Yeah, Brian Kelly does great in the regular season every single year. This guy can't win a friggin' postseason game if his life depended on it. Go look at Notre Dame's record in the postseason. Yes, Brian Kelly's a pretty good coach for the first 12 games of the year. That ain't breaking news. Dummy, he's been that for a long time. But look what happens to Brian Kelly when he has to play a 13th or a 14th game. He shits the fucking bed every goddamn time. Hell, that one year they even made it to the ACC title game. They got humiliated. Remember that? In the ACC title game. Every single major bowl game he made it to, he got humiliated. That was at Notre Dame. Yeah, it was because of Brian Kelly. God damn. Brian Kelly's getting an early start on his postseason retardedness by go ahead and losing the last game of the regular season to a terrible Texas A&M team. I can't wait till next Saturday when Georgia just beats the absolute life out of LSU, the damn corn dogs. And why are the corn dogs so loud? I'm live streaming last night during the LSU game while they're getting their soul yanked out of their body through their asshole, and LSU fans are in the comment section telling me, you know, Georgia ain't unbeatable, dude. They're not unbeatable. You don't have to be unbeatable to beat LSU. You just have to be slightly better than don't suck ass to beat LSU. Y'all are a joke. LSU, you got humiliated. Who's next on this shit list here?